Okay, welcome to another Orbiter 2010 video, and this video is going to be another installment in my absolute beginner guide, the video series that I'm putting together that has a special focus on people who are brand new to Orbiter. In the last several videos, we've been looking at how we can build up our toolkit, how we can add some additional MFDs to make navigating the solar system a little bit easier, and we're going to continue with that type of video in this particular installment. We're going to talk a little bit about how to download and install the XR2 Ravenstar. That's one of the most popular vessels in all of Orbiter, and for good reason. It's one of the most highly developed, most complete vessels that's available. So let me go ahead and switch camera views here. And what we're going to do is we're going to download these three files, which are the XR2 Ravenstar itself, plus the requirements that it has. So we're going to get that from the Altea Aerospace website. At least we're going to get the Ravenstar from the Altea Aerospace website. And again, I'll provide a link in the description down below, so you don't necessarily need to try to write that down or anything. But you come to the Altea Aerospace website, and you'll go to the downloads, which is located up here on the top. And you'll notice here that it has this note, the XR vessels require, it doesn't say that it recommends, it requires Dansteff's UMMU 2.0 or higher. And it also requires Orbiter Sound 3.5 or higher. And it even gives you a link here that you can click where you can actually go and download those. So since these are the requirements for the XR2, let's take care of that first. So when you click this link, it's going to take you to Dansteff's website, which is orbiter.dansteff.com. Again, I'll put this link in the description down below. And you're going to want to get Orbiter Sound 4.0. This is the newest one. You can use the Ravenstar with Orbiter Sound 3.5. But there's no reason not to use the newest version of Orbiter Sound. So download that simply by clicking the download button here and then save it, somewhere that you can remember in your downloads or on your desktop or whatever. The second thing you're going to need from this website as part of the requirement for the XR2 Ravenstar is the UMMU 2.0 or higher. And again, 2.5 is the current release. So go ahead and grab that. Click download there and save that again somewhere that you'll be able to find it, such as your desktop. It wouldn't hurt if you wanted to actually grab UCGO 2.5 plus UMMU 2.5. This combines the UCGO and UMMU together. So instead of getting that here, you would instead get this. I say that's not necessarily a bad idea because the UCGO comes with the very cool Aero Freighter, which I've debuted in some of my videos in the past. I really like the Aero Freighter. I think it's just an amazing vessel. It gives you that sort of starship type of feeling, and it's really fun to fly that when you're going out to the outer planets. It gives more of an immersive experience rather than being cooped up inside of a small XR vessel or the Delta Glider. But your choice on that, grab either this one, which meets the requirement, or grab this combination here. So once you have those downloaded, then here on the Altea Aerospace website, you'll want to scroll down a little bit on the downloads page and download the XR2 Ravenstar 1.6A. It's the current version. Of course, by the time you see this video, some point in the future, there may be a newer version yet. But grab whatever the newest version is. And if you want, you can also grab the Vanguard. I like to fly the Vanguard as well. It's fun, so if you want to grab that as well. And then you could also, if you want, grab the Delta Glider XR1. The Delta Glider XR1 is basically, it gives you the same look as the standard Delta Glider, but it gives you all of the functionality that you would find in the XR2. So, for example, you have the attitude hold autopilot, so you can keep a steep reentry, a steep angle of attack for reentry. And I believe it also has locks and other types of things like that that the standard Delta glider doesn't have. But here in this video, we're just really focusing on the XR2 Ravenstar. So those are the three files that you need to download. And once you have them downloaded, you can pretty much install them in any order, I believe. But it makes sense to install the requirements first. I'm guessing most people probably already have Orbiter Sound installed. I haven't actually covered that in any of my previous videos, but most people who have Orbiter installed and working probably have already installed Orbiter Sound. But if for some reason you haven't, once you have Orbiter Sound 4.0 downloaded, simply double click it, and Windows will give you, some kind of authentication warning, which I guess actually doesn't show up in the video playback, but here on my screen I can see it. And the way you install this one is a bit different, obviously, than the previous MFDs that we've installed, where we just open the zip file and drag and drop. With Orbiter Sound and with the UMMU and or UCGO, it's an actual executable program that you run, and hopefully you're familiar with file system management so you can understand what's happening here. But all we have to do is point, quote unquote, point this installer to our Orbiter 2010 directory, wherever that happens to be. So click Browse and then navigate, your file system and tell the installer where you have Orbiter 2010 installed. So for example, here, this actually isn't a complete installation here on my desktop, but this is where I've been demonstrating the installation of MFDs and such. So I would point the Windows Explorer, I would tell it to go to, Orbiter 2010 on my desktop, and then hit OK, and that would install Orbiter Sound to that location. And then I would repeat the process for the UMMU or UCGO, whichever one of those you happen to download. Just double click it, it's an executable, and it's going to ask you where you want to install to. So tell it you want to install to your Orbiter directory, wherever that happens to be on your system, and it will install there. Finally, once you have those installed, you're going to need to install the XR2 Ravenstar, and this works more like the previous examples that we've shown, where we actually just double click the zip file here, and that's going to open up this folder. Open up this zip folder, and inside of it is all of the content that make up the XR2 Ravenstar. And the way you install it is the same as the way we installed the different MFDs, like Aerobrake MFD and Burn Time Calculator. You just highlight the whole thing, everything in here, and then drag that over and drop it onto your Orbiter directory, and let that copy the contents into the Orbiter directory, and that's actually how you install it. In this case, we do want to install everything that you see here. Technically, the dock is not necessary, but the documentation for the XR vessels is very high quality. It's not just a plain text file, and it's not just a generic PDF. The XR flight manual is extremely high quality, so I highly recommend that you install the dock as well, and even take the time to at least skim through the manual so you have some familiarity with it. So again, don't exclude anything here. You need everything. There's no Orbiter SDK or anything like that, so we need everything that we have here for the XR2. And if you happen to have downloaded the XR5 Vanguard and or the Delta Glider XR1, then you would repeat the process. Open those zip files, highlight everything, drag it and drop it into your Orbiter 2010 directory, and then you will be all set. Once you've done that, then you can open Orbiter. And they think the only thing that we have to make sure that we have is the Orbiter Sound module. This will, when you install Orbiter Sound, it will enable the module for you if you allow it to do that, or if you say yes. I believe it asks you if you want to enable the sound module or not, and as long as you said yes, then it will already be enabled. But just double check. Come when you start Orbiter, go to the modules, and just make sure that Orbiter Sound is highlighted, or rather is checked. There's nothing for the XR2 or XR5 or anything like that. There's no modules that have to be enabled for those. But to make sure that everything is working for your XR2, you will have a couple of directories that were installed by default for some of the scenarios. So if you go into the XR2 Ravenstar folder in the scenarios and just pick any one, I think doc.iss is a pretty good choice. Hit launch orbiter, and of course that will bring up orbiter. And why is this not in full screen mode? That's weird. I'll have to check on that.
Welcome aboard, Commander. All systems nominal.
And I must have started the wrong instance of orbiter, that's why. So at any rate, you can clearly see that the XR2 is installed and working. So just press F1, you can kind of look outside, see that we are in fact here docked at the ISS, and we have our instrument panel down here. Press F8 a couple times and you can kind of look around the virtual cockpit, and you can have that 2D glass cockpit view as well. So that's how you can validate that you did in fact install the XR2 correctly. And if you want to just kind of maybe go through some of the functionality of the XR2 by turning on the APU, and yeah, that's, let me actually exit out of this. I started the wrong instance of orbiter, so I'm gonna have to start, that's this one here. This has my D3, D9 client, which is much better. And there's actually one other thing I want to mention about the XR2, or actually all the XR vessels in general, so let me go ahead and start that scenario back up. Now we have full screen. But if you turn the APU on, you can close the radiator, open the radiator, close the air brake, open the air brake, open the hover doors, close the hover doors, things like that, just to sort of verify that everything is working as you expect. The one thing I did want to mention before ending the video, though, is your particular view of the XR2 cockpit may not look like mine. And the reason for that is because my screen resolution is 1920 wide by 1080. If you are running a lower resolution, like 1600 by 900, or especially if you're down into like 1280 by 1024 or anything like that, you'll find that your view of the cockpit is narrower. You won't have as many of these buttons. For example, here I've got, you know, the retro doors, the hover doors, the scram doors. You may find if you're running a lower resolution that some of these buttons don't appear in this particular view. But if you press control, that's the control key on your keyboard, hold it down and tap the up arrow key, then you'll get access to this upper panel. And all of the buttons that you do not see here will appear up here in addition to or instead of down here. And you can also press control down arrow one more time to get access to this lower panel. But depending on your particular screen resolution, your view of the standard 2D panel here will vary. In some cases, it will vary considerably. Okay, so I think that covers everything pretty well. We can't really get into, you know, explaining all the uses and all the various ways that you can use the XR2 in just one short video. But I will be showing the XR2 more in upcoming videos so we can actually see what the difference between it and the Delta Glider is and why we would generally tend to prefer something more along the lines of the XR2, because it's a little bit more sophisticated. It has better features, you know, like, for example, we have locks in this vessel. That's liquid oxygen, and by default we have about 14 days worth, whereas when you fly the standard Delta Glider, there's no oxygen depletion, so you can fly all the way to Pluto and back and not run out of air, and that's a little ridiculous. So it's kind of cool to have a vessel like this one that limits you, so that, you know, here we have enough to go to the moon and back without resupplying, But if we wanted to go any farther than that, then we would have to carry some additional oxygen. That's just one of the cool things about the XR2. And we also have the scram engines in this vessel, which allow for some pretty neat ideas as well. If you liked the video, hit the like button. If you didn't like the video, hit the don't like button. Subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed. Check out the description for a link to my Facebook page where you can get access to that, where you can see all my videos that I post, plus other space-related content. Be sure to check that out, and I will see you in the next video.